in the Anguttara Nikaya, the Buddha said, in the future, there may be some monk who is very senior and very famous, so famous that he has a lot of disciples, monk disciples, nun disciples, and lay person disciples, a large following. And he may be very learned in the scriptures, in the books. But in spite of all that, he still can have wrong view. So don't think that some monk is world famous, that everything he teaches is correct. That is why when the Buddha was about to enter Nibbana, Venerable Ananda asked him, Bhagava, after you are gone, whom should we follow as our teacher? They probably thought that the Buddha was going to appoint Venerable Kassapa or somebody as the successor. The Buddha said no. The Buddha said, after I am gone, take the Dhamma Vinaya as your teacher. Also in another sutta, in Anguttara Nikaya, the Buddha said, if some monk says that such and such is the Buddha's teachings, don't welcome it, but don't scorn it also. Compare what he says with the suttas and the Vinaya. If it is in agreement with the suttas and it is in agreement with the Vinaya, take that to be the Buddha's words and follow it. But if it contradicts the suttas and it contradicts the Vinaya, then you can be sure that it's not the Buddha's words and reject it. So, Vinaya, you see, concerns monks. Nowadays, only monks. So for lay people, your teacher, now that the Buddha is not around, is the suttas. And I've tried to point this out in a book I wrote called Liberation. I did not bring many copies because books are heavy to carry. I gave 4 copies to Brother Gore. Another 4 copies on meditation to Brother Gore. If you all are interested, you can either photostat it or reprint it. Doesn't cost very much to reprint, less than $1, provided you print 2,000 or 3,000 copies. So I think I'll take a breather and invite any questions.